Hi everyone, this video is for previous year questions from electrochemistry topic. So I have selected questions from June 2011. This is part 1 of the series. Let's solve problems. First question: 4M aqueous solution at 25 degrees Celsius. The Debye-Huckel limiting law is given by. So what you have to find? The Debye-Huckel limiting law. It's very simple basic question, so I haven't given the options here. So I hope you know the Debye-Huckel limiting law, that is log gamma plus or minus equal to minus 0.509. So remember, there is a minus sign, minus 0.509 modulus z plus z minus root of mu or ionic strength. So minus 0.509 z plus z minus root mu, that's the Debye-Huckel limiting law. Moving on to second question, given Ag plus giving Ag, EMF 0.50 volt, then copper 2 plus giving copper E0 0.34 volt. A 100 ml solution is 1080 milligram with respect to Ag plus. So in a 100 ml solution, the weight of Ag plus is 1080 milligram and 635 milligram of Cu2 plus. Cu2 plus, what's the weight? 635 milligram. If 0.1 milligram Ag plus left in the solution is considered to be the complete deposition of Ag plus, the cathode potential so that no copper is deposited during the process. So the question is, we have to find the cathode potential. What the cathode potential? So that the no copper is deposited during the process. So you have to find the cathode potential at which no more copper deposition occur. So using the given data, equation for E cell equal to E0 cell minus 0.0591 by n log 1 by mn plus. Mn plus here, what is copper 2 plus? Copper 2 plus. Then E0 cell of copper 2 plus is given as 0.34 volt. 0.34 minus 0.0591 by n is what? N is number of electrons. Number of electrons involved in copper, this reaction is 2 electrons. 2 log of 1 by concentration of Cu2 plus. So you have to find the concentration of Cu2 plus. For that, how there is given data, 100 ml solution, 635 milligram of copper 2 plus. In 100 ml solution, 635 milligram, that means 10 raised to minus 3 gram is present, and molar mass is what? 63.5 gram. So you can easily find the molarity. Molarity is what? Concentration or molarity is given mass, that is 635 into 10 raised to minus 3 divided by molar mass, 63.5 into volume. Volume is 100 ml, that means 0.1 liter. So 635 into 10 raised to minus 3 by 63.5 into 0.1. So you can substitute that value, 1 divided by 635 into 10 raised to minus 3 by 63.5 into 0.1. So when solving this, you will get 10. So the answer will be 0.34 minus 0.059 by 2, 91 by 2 log 10. Log 10 is 1. So 0.34 minus 0.0591 by 2. So solving this, you will get EMF 0.31 volt. So E cell equal to 0.31 volt. That means when the reaction reach 0.31 volt, the copper deposition starts. copper deposition starts when 0.31 volt reached. Copper deposition starts at 0.31 volt. So the EMF should be around 0.31 volt. So the option is 0.31 volt. C option. Third question. Debye-Huckel screening length K inverse is a measure of size of diffuse ion cloud around an ion provided root of 2 E square Na by epsilon 0 KBT approximately equal to 30 nanometer root of mole per kilogram at 298 Kelvin. The following values of K inverse is true for a 0.03 molar solution for Na2SO4 in water. Epsilon R equal to 100. What we have to find? Debye-Huckel screening length, that is K inverse, should be found out. And it is measure of size and it is given root 2 E square Na by epsilon 0 KBT is 30. And temperature is given 298 Kelvin and the compound is Na2SO4. So the equation for K is E square Na by epsilon 0 epsilon R KBT, Boltzmann constant, into sigma I Ci Zi square, and this is whole root E square Na by epsilon 0 epsilon R KBT sigma I Ci Zi square. That's the equation. Question, it is given root of 2 E square Na by epsilon 0 KBT. So we can separate these parts from equation 1. How? Writing this equation 1 in parts, K equal to root of sigma Ci Zi square into 1 by root of epsilon R. And I am multiplying with 2 in numerator and denominator. So 2 epsilon R into root of 2 E square Na by epsilon 0 KBT. This is very simple, just separating each part. So first part is sigma Ci Zi square, then multiplying with 2 on numerator and denominator, then 1 by root 2 epsilon R, that this part, then rest of the part is root 2 E square Na by epsilon 0 KBT. That's given in the question as 30. So substituting the value, root of sigma Ci Zi square divided by root of 2 epsilon R into 30. And the unit is also given, nanometer root mole per kilogram. Finding root of sigma Ci Zi square, how to find? Ci means concentration. Ci concentration 0.03 molar. It's given in question. Then Zi is charge for Na2SO4 2Na plus and SO4 2 minus. So for Na plus, how many number? 2, and 2 into Na plus charge is 1. So you can easily find out Ci Zi square. Sigma Ci Zi square is first 2 into, that's Na into 0.03 into charge 1 square plus, then SO4 2 minus, only 1 atom, then 1 into 0.03 into charge is what? 2. 2 square, or minus 2 the whole square, that is 2 square. Here root of 2 into 0.03 into 1 square plus 0.03 into 2 square into 30, the whole divided by root of 2 into epsilon R. Epsilon R is what? It is given in question as 100. Root of 0.18 divided by 10 root 2 into 30 equal to 9 by 10 nanometer inverse. And that's the value of K. So K is 9 by 10. K equal to 9 by 10. and we have to find K inverse. K inverse equal to 10 by 9 nanometer. Here it is nanometer inverse, and K inverse is 10 by 9 nanometer. So the answer is 10 by 9 nanometer, A option. Fourth question, if the ratio of composition of oxidized and reduced species in electrochemical cell is given as O by R, that is oxidized species concentration divided by concentration of reduced species equal to E square, the correct potential difference will be, we have to find the potential difference, that is E minus E zero cell. E minus E zero cell should be find out. And what is the equation? E equal to E zero cell minus R T by N F ln reduced species concentration divided by oxidized species R by O. That's the equation. So when you shift E zero cell to left hand side, E minus E zero equal to minus RT by NF ln R by O. It is given O by R. Concentration of O by R is E square. So R by O will be 1 by E square. 1 by E square equal to minus RT by NF ln 1 by E square can be written as E raised to minus 2 equal to minus RT by NF into ln E raised to minus 2 minus 2 into ln E. Solving this, minus RT by NF E is 1, ln E equal to 1. So minus 2 equal to 2RT by NF. The potential difference will be 2RT by NF. Fifth question, for a potentiometric titration in the curve of EMF versus volume of the titrant, the equivalence point is indicated by. We have to find the equivalence point indication expression. So the graph of this potentiometric titration EMF versus volume of titrant is like this. So this is the general graph for EMF versus volume potentiometric titration. And from this graph you will get DE and DV. First like this, and this is the point, equivalence point. And this DE DV, DE by DV is the slope. DE by DV is the slope. And one important point is there. Rate of change in slope. Rate of change in slope has maximum value at equivalence point. So rate of change in slope has maximum value at equivalence point. This point you can write d by dv of slope. DE by DV, rate of change of slope has maximum value at equivalence point, means d by dv of DE by DV will be 0. So d by dv of DE by DV is 0. That means d into dE is d square e by dv into dv, that is dv square. D square e by dv square equal to 0. D square e by dv square equal to 0. So you got first expression. So in options d square e by dv square is 0. In A option it is given dE square by dv square equal to 0. So that's not right. Then d square e by dv square equal to 0 in C option. Okay, that's right. Then in B option, D option is also wrong. Modulus of dE by dv is always positive. Modulus of any number is positive. So dE by dv should be positive value. That means greater than 0. So C option is the right, dE by dV. Modulus of dE by dV is greater than 0 and modulus of d square E by dV square is 0. Sixth question, the overall reaction for the passage of 1 Faraday of charge in the following cell is given by T is transport number. So a reaction is given, we have to find the overall reaction. First Ag converted to AgCl. So that's an oxidation reaction, anode reaction. So that's an anode reaction, oxidation Ag plus Cl minus give AgCl plus electron. That's anode reaction. So next one will be cathode reaction, reduction reaction, cathode reaction, reduction. Then AgCl converted to Ag, AgCl plus electron give Ag plus Cl minus. That's cathode reaction. And here in anode reaction, the concentration of Cl minus is A1, concentration A1, and in cathode A2. Now looking on the equation, there is no salt bridge. So if there is no salt bridge, that means this K plus and Cl minus will transfer among the reaction. So there is transference. So we have to write the equations of migration of K plus and Cl minus. And how will you find the direction of migration? Whether K plus is moving to A2 or from A2 to A1. So for that, we have to consider the anion here. What is the anion? Cl minus. Why? Cell is reversible with anion Cl minus. Respect of Cl minus. First you consider the Cl minus production. Where is Cl minus production? In cathode. In cathode the Cl minus is produced. So from A2 to A1 should be the transference of Cl minus. From production to A1, A2 to A1 will be the migration of Cl minus. Migration of Cl minus will be from production A2. A2 to A1. That means transport number should be T minus Cl minus A2, T minus Cl minus A1. T minus Cl minus A2, T minus Cl minus A1. And the reverse of Cl minus will be migration of K plus. That means A1 to A2. A1 to A2 will be migration of K plus. And transport number will be T plus K plus, T plus K plus, T plus K plus A1 to T plus K plus A2. Now adding all these four equation, adding four equations, you will get overall reaction. Overall reaction. Overall reaction will be adding all these equation. When you add all this equation, what happened? Ag plus Cl minus plus AgCl plus electron. When you add these two reactions, this Ag and Ag will be cancelled. This Cl minus A1 and this is Cl minus A2. And electrons cancelled, AgCl cancelled. So C equation will be Cl minus A1 plus T plus K plus A1 plus T minus Cl minus A2 giving Cl minus A2 plus T plus K plus A2 plus C minus Cl minus A1. Then Cl minus A1 and Cl minus A2. Equation will be T plus K plus A1 plus T plus Cl minus A1 giving T plus K plus A2 plus T plus Cl minus A2. So that's the final equation, and when you add this you will get in terms of KCl. So T plus KCl A1 giving T plus KCl A2. So A1 to A2 in terms of KCL. A1 to A2, that's the first option. A1 to A2. Or you can directly write A1 to A2 by looking on the K plus term. Only K plus term, A1 to A2. Why? The cell is reversible with respect to Cl minus. So you will look on the other cation, that is other ion, that is cation K plus. So T plus K plus A1 giving T plus K plus A2. Seventh question, the standard electrode potential of Fe3 plus bar Fe2 plus and Fe2 plus bar Fe electrodes are 0.77 volt and minus 0.44 volt at 300 Kelvin. The E0 of Fe3 plus bar Fe electrode at the same temperature is. So the reactions given are Fe3 plus 2 Fe2 plus. Fe3 plus plus electron give Fe2 plus. Then next reaction is Fe2 plus giving Fe. Fe2 plus 2 electron give Fe. And first EMF is 0.77 volt and the second reaction minus 0.44 volt. So adding these equation you will get what? Fe3 plus plus electrons, one electron here, two electrons, so total three electrons. Then here Fe2 plus and left hand side Fe2 plus cancelled out and final Fe. Fe3 plus plus three electron gives Fe. That's the question asked, Fe3 plus 2 Fe. And what's the question? EMF. We have to find the E0. So there is an equation for finding E0, delta G equal to minus NF E0 cell. Minus NF E0 cell. So let's assume this as delta G3. So this is delta G1, then second delta G2, and this is delta G3. We have to find delta G3. So for finding delta G3, how to find out? Just adding delta G1 and delta G2. Delta G1 plus delta G2 gives delta G3. Delta G1 is minus N, number of electrons involved in first reaction, one electron, F into E0 cell, 0.77 volt plus minus N 2F, E0 cell is minus 0.44 volt equal to delta G3. Delta G3 is minus number of electrons 3F E0 cell. Solving this, you will get minus 3F E0 cell equal to minus 0.77F plus 0.88F. Minus 3F E0 cell equal to 0.11 Faraday. Then E0 equal to 0.11F divided by minus 3F equal to 0.11 divided by 3 equal to minus 0.04 volt. So the answer is minus 0.04, D option. Eighth question, the molar conductivities at infinite dilution lambda 0 m for Na2SO4, K2SO4, KCl, HCl and HCONa at 300 Kelvin are 260, 308, 150, 426, 105 Siemens centimeter inverse per mole square. Hence lambda 0 m for formic acid in same unit and same temperature is. What we have to find? Lambda 0 m for formic acid HCOOH and given data for Na2SO4, then KCl, HCl, HCOONa, HCOONa plus HCl added. So you will get what? HCOOH and an extra NaCl. So we have to minus subtract this NaCl lambda 0 m. Molar conductivity of NaCl should be subtracted from. So we have to find lambda 0 m of NaCl. We have to find lambda 0 m of NaCl. So for finding lambda 0 m of NaCl, you can use these given datas. Lambda 0 m of NaCl equal to lambda 0 m of Na2SO4 by 2. That is half of lambda 0 m of Na2SO4 plus lambda 0 m of KCl minus half of lambda 0 m of K2SO4. So when you solve this, you will get lambda 0 m of NaCl. Half into Na2SO4 260 plus KCl. KCl is given as 150. 150 minus half into K2SO4. Value of K2SO4 lambda 0 m is 308. 30 plus 150 minus 154 equal to 126. And we have to find HCOOH. So for that, first you add HCOONa and HCl. HCOONa lambda 0 m of HCOOH equal to lambda 0 m of HCOONa. HCOONa is given as 105. Then plus HCl. HCl is 426. Minus NaCl, that is 126, equal to 405 siemen per centimeter per mole square. So the answer is 405. Then the spectrophotometric response for titration of a mixture of Fe3 plus and Cu2 plus ions against EDTA is given below. So the graph is the spectrophotometric response of titration of Fe3 plus and Cu2 plus. So this mixture is what? Fe3 plus and Cu2 plus mixture against EDTA. So in this EDTA titration, Fe3 plus and Cu2 plus are reacting with the EDTA. So we have to find which one react faster, Fe3 plus or Cu2 plus. So Fe3 plus is small ion, smaller in size, Fe3 plus, due to higher charge, Fe3 plus, smaller size. So smaller size ion will react or form complex fast. Smaller ion will react or form complex fast. So Fe3 plus will first react with EDTA. Fe3 plus first react with EDTA and form a complex. So that will be the first stage of the reaction, first stage. So in the graph AB is the first stage and BC is the second stage and CD is the third stage. So in first stage, what happened? Fe3 plus and EDTA react. So AB will be Fe3 plus concentration. Fe3 plus concentration. AB. So in first option, AB Fe3 plus. In second option, it is copper 2 plus. So that's wrong. Then AB 3 plus. Then D option, Cu2 plus. So option A, C is left. Looking on to CD. CD is what? In AB, the first stage is Fe3 plus forming EDTA. Then equivalence point is reached. Equivalence point, what happens? This left Cu2 plus. Cu2 plus will form complex with EDTA in second stage. Second stage. So BC will be about Cu2 plus EDTA complex. And the last stage, CD. Third stage is what? The EDTA excess EDTA left in the reaction. Presence excess EDTA. CD is excess EDTA. And option C. Option C is the right answer. Question: the correct value of E0 of a half cell in the following graph of E versus log M is given. So a graph is given where E, EMF is the y-axis and log M is the x-axis. A graph is given and we have to find correct E0, standard EMF from the graph. So which axis represents the EMF? So what is the equation for E cell? E equal to E0 minus RT by F or NF, NF ln 1 by mn plus concentration of mn plus. This equation can be written as E0 plus, minus is converted to plus, then RT by NF, then ln 1 by mn plus will become mn plus because of minus charge. Minus charge converting to plus charge. So E0 plus RT by NF ln mn plus. And this is in the form of Y equal to mx plus C. Y equal to mx plus C. Y is E, EMF. Then M is the slope and X is the X axis. X is what? Log M. E is the intercept. C is the intercept. Intercept, here intercept is what? E0. E0 is the intercept. So E0 will be intercept. So we have to find the E0 value. So from the graph you can find the intercept, y intercept, which is y intercept here, B. Then B, B dash will be the y intercept. B, B dash is the y intercept. 11th question, the correct Nernst equation for the concentration cell without liquid junction potential would be. So a reaction, concentration cell reaction is given and we have to find the correct Nernst equation. So for a concentration cell without liquid junction potential and with the transference, the Nernst equation E equal to RT by F ln concentration A2 by A1. Ln A2 by A1. This is the concentration cell equation with transference. So from this equation you can write easily the Nernst equation for given reaction. So in given reaction it is H2HCl, AgCl-Ag and AgAgCl-HCl then H2. So writing the equation 2RT by F ln A2 means concentration, second concentration, that is here it is written as A plus O minus 2, this one, divided by A1 means A plus O minus 1. So that's the equation 2RT by F ln A plus O minus 2 by A plus O minus 1. So from option, the C option, C option is the right answer. 12th question, mean assumptions involved in derivation of Debye-Huckel equation is or are the validity of only Poisson equation, Poisson equation, Boltzmann distribution, Poisson equation, Boltzmann distribution and plus or minus ZE phi greater than KBT, Poisson equation, Boltzmann distribution and plus or minus ZE phi less than KBT. So this is a theory part question and it is given that Debye-Huckel equation, Debye-Huckel equation is derived from Poisson equation, Boltzmann distribution. The equation charge density rho equal to minus Z 2n square E square psi by kT. This is the equation for charge density. And this question is part of derivation of Debye-Huckel equation and it's a lengthy process. So just remember that Debye-Huckel equation is derived from Poisson equation, Boltzmann distribution and one more thing is what? ZE phi. ZE phi means this ZE psi. ZE phi is assumed to be less than KT. it is less than kt because it is minus z 2 n square e square psi by kt. So it will be less than kt value. So from the option, the right answer is the option Poisson equation, Boltzmann distribution plus or minus z phi less than kt. 13th question, for the deposition of lead by electroplating the best suited compound among the following is PbCl2, PbSO4, PbET4, PbBF4 twice. PbCl2 and PbSO4, these are ionic compounds. These are ionic compounds and they are insoluble in water. Insoluble in cold water. So that cannot be used for deposition of Pb. Then PbET4 is a toxic compound, very toxic compound. So the left option is PbBF4 twice. 14th question, the Daniell cell is, very simple question, Daniell cell is what? Zinc 2 plus and salt bridge copper 2 plus giving copper. So this is the representation for Daniell cell. So by looking on this representation, you can easily find out the right answer. First option, PT, platinum, that's inert electrode. Zinc 2 plus, Cu 2 plus, Cu PT 2. So that's the right answer. And looking on other options, it is given silver in second and iron in third and H2SO4 in D option. So A is the right answer.